From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Last year, a judge sentenced Daniel Fortune to two concurrent life sentences for a 2008 machete attack in Pittston.
Today, the Supreme Judicial Court will hear oral arguments in Fortune's appeal case at Elizabeth High School, all part of an effort to educate students about the judicial branch of government. In June of 2010, a judge sentenced Daniel Fortune to serve two concurrent life sentences behind bars. A month earlier, a Somerset County jury convicted Fortune for the 2008 machete attack on a family in Pittston, left a father and a daughter with permanent brain injuries.
Police in Dover, New Hampshire, and Amtrak officials are now investigating the death of a man hit by the Downeaster. Police say a 50-year-old man from New Hampshire was hit as he was walking just north of the Washington Street overpass in Dover. This happened just before 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon. Police say that the train was traveling southbound and just tried to stop but couldn't do so in time. The man later died at the hospital.
Portland's new disorderly housing law has only been active for 5 months, but already police say it's reduced the number of disturbances in problem areas. The law enacted back in May fines landlords for refusing to address rowdy tenants and criminal behavior at their buildings. A home is labeled disorderly if police are called out three times or more in a month. Since May, 25 apartment buildings have been classified as disorderly homes, which means landlords have to meet with police to fix the problems plaguing that building.
Oh, definitely. It's rare we'll have a disorderly house, meet with the landlord, get a plan in place, and then have it declared a disorderly house again. It's very rare. So in other words, the calls go right down.
And we like it. It's quiet now. It doesn't seem to be too updropped and loud. We've only maybe seen the cops here twice in the past 2 months, when it used to be when we first moved in, it was like 9 to 20 times in a month.
Disorderly housing law has been so effective, in fact, that South Portland and Biddeford have also enacted laws modeled after the one in Portland.
Well, $81 million, that is the price to replace the aging bridge linking Maine and New Hampshire. According to New Hampshire's DOT officials, a Chicago-based contracting firm called Archer Western won the bid to take down the aging 88-year-old bridge and build a new one. Officials say the contractor hopes to have the new bridge open by July of 2013, the bridge permanently closed to all motor vehicle traffic this past July because of unsafe conditions.
The annual Cans for a Cure fundraiser continues today in the Main Mall parking lot. People can drop off bottles and cans, and the money raised goes to help fight breast cancer. It is put on by radio station WJBQ. Morning DJ's Lori Vornitz and Meredith Manning are camping out until they reach their goal of 45,000 cans. And this year has special meaning. Their co-host, Jeff Parsons, was recently diagnosed with cancer.
10 years, and this is so ironic that he would end up finding out just a few weeks ago that he has cancer. You know, it just brought it so close to home. We all know someone who has it, but when it's someone who you work with every day, it's part of your family, you know, it really hits you hard.
If you want to help, you still have time. You can drop off bottles, cans, even donations at the big semi in the main mall parking lot. Can't miss it. They'll be there until they reach their goal of 450,000 cans and bottles.
Go help them out.
Yeah, great cause.
Well, thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Great minds think alike. We're back in a few. Have a great weekend, everyone.